Okay, so esophageal varices are a problem that originates in the liver. What happens when cirrhosis progresses is that as it progresses, the liver develops scar tissue. As that scar tissue continues to progress across the liver, it begins to limit blood flow. Okay, and we know we have a couple really major veins within our liver. We have our portal hepatic vein, and what happens is that as the blood flow becomes obstructed through there, the liver starts looking for other places to send all that blood flow, okay? So as that blood flow starts to shunt to other locations, it begins to move to places like the esophagus and right around the stomach. So right next to the liver, we have all these veins along the stomach and within the esophagus as well, okay? So the blood begins to shunt, and it shunts to the esophagus, and it shunts to kind of the stomach as well. So the lower part of the esophagus and the stomach, these little veins along there become very dilated, okay? These are not huge veins, these aren't big veins, they're much smaller veins, but what happens is as that, all that pressure from that liver blood flow begins to force into those areas, to the esophagus, is those veins become very, very dilated, okay? So here's our esophagus, and so that those veins along there become very dilated as that liver blood begins to push into there. So that dilation of those veins along the esophagus is known as esophageal varices. Now the risk with these is like I said, these are very weak veins, so they can rupture. Okay, as that pressure builds within them, it builds and builds and builds, and it continues to dilate, and finally, eventually, it will just rupture. Now that's a huge concern because like I said, there's so much blood flowing through there. So as that liver blood continues to come into the liver and then shunts away into the esophagus, if those rupture, you have a tremendous amount of blood that begins to spill out. Okay, so your patient can lose a ton of blood. One of the ways they can lose blood is from these esophageal varices rupturing and then they just start to spew out blood. Just huge and huge copious amounts of blood, okay? So what we can do for these patients is we can insert what's called a Blakemore tube, okay? And this tube goes in through the mouth, down the esophagus, and then into the upper portion of the stomach, okay? And on this tube, there's a balloon at the end of it. There's a balloon that you can inflate, and the balloon will press against the wall of the esophagus and in the upper portion of the stomach, and it will push pressure against these varices, okay? So as it pushes that pressure against there, against those walls, it prevents these veins from rupturing, okay? So we insert the tube almost just like you're doing an NG tube or an OG tube or something like that. So you just kind of insert it like you're doing an OG tube, and then there's little ports where you can fill it with air, and it fills that with air, compressing against the walls of the esophagus and the stomach. And that's going to prevent the rupture of those veins. Okay, so that's really kind of what we do for these patients. And again, the whole goal with this is to prevent that rupture and prevent that tremendous amount of blood loss. Okay, so that's really a basic overview of esophageal varices and what we kind of do with the Blakemore tube it's called like a balloon tamponade here that we do to prevent the rupturing of those esophageal varices. All right?